All right. The Garden of Eden, Hazard has shown up. That was a masterful performance. That was a low replication, and he reincarnated Hungary. He ran the show. For the whole 90 minutes, he ran the show. So I don't want to even put an asterisk behind it. People can say, okay, it's Hungary, how they played and so forth. And I'll get to how Hungary played and how that was a detriment to them. I've got to give it up. Hazard, that is Hazard at his best. You know, the playmaker, the dribbler, running with the ball, making use of the space, creating chances, and just totally being involved in every single facet of Belgium's attacking play. It was a masterful performance, absolutely amazing. So, no qualms about that. Hungary, they played the wrong tactics. Because for me, I thought that, you know, the manager would be tactically better than Wilmot, but tactically they didn't. They played the wrong tactics in this game. Even when they went a goal down, I thought that, defend, keep it tight. You're still in the game, but keep it tight. Be defensive, because you have guys who can counter and you have guys who can exploit the space of Belgium who are not that great defensively. So at 1-0, it's fine. Keep it tight. You don't have to push too many men forward. But they made the game a wild, wild west, and which is why I say to people, if you make a game a wild, wild west, 10 times out of 10, not 9, 10 times out of 10, the team with the better player will always win. That's a fact. If you play open warfare, huge space, you hit us, we hit you back, the team with the better players, 10 times out of 10, will always win. And with this, because being by the law of averages, Belgium would take their chances a lot more than Hungary would, because Belgium just have better players than Hungary do. So it was bad tactics for Hungary to give Belgium that much space, and they kill them for it. But I think the basic thing with Belgium is this: if you give them space, Belgium can beat the Euros. If, let's say, Belgium played every team and they gave them that amount of space, Belgium can win these Euros, because no other team has the kind of wingers that they do. And remember, this football has changed into a game where it's about attacking wingers right now. And if you give attacking wingers space, so these attacking wingers who can cross, can create, and they can also score as well, i.e. De Bruyne and Hazard, you're going to get killed. You are going to get killed. I think for Lukaku, I still think that Wilmot needs to find a striker who fits in with Hazard and De Bruyne. But I still think that Lukaku is useful. Lukaku is useful if you're playing a tighter team, because it's always good to have that option of, like, okay, if it's not going happening between Hazard and De Bruyne, you always have Lukaku who can be there that you can feed the ball into. But I think, you know, for Hungary, it's just, yes, they played wrong tactically, but they still were involved in what was a very entertaining game, and they never gave up. They kept on attacking. So for Hungary, it was an amazing effort by them, and I just liked what they did. And for Zoltán Gyarmán, it's a good way to go out. This is how you lose. The way Croatia lost, you don't lose like that. This is how you lose, as in, you went out blazing. You went out guns blazing, because Hungary created a lot of chances. They created some very, very good chances, but they were not able to put them away. But the only question I have for Belgium is, obviously we'll get to Wales and I'll get to that, but they won't be able to play like this against a team who are much more defensive and much more physical and deny them a lot of space and not commit that many men forward. So for Belgium, they can't rest on these laurels. They know that if you give us space, we will baptize you. That's what Belgium have said to everyone in the Euros, that do not give us space. The only way you can play against us is you have to deny space, be defensive and be tight. You see, Belgium, I think, would give Spain problems. They'd give Germany problems. Against Italy, you know, against Italy or even against Portugal, the very defensive-minded teams, I don't know. I don't know whether they would give them that many issues. So, but all in all, man, for Hazard, I just wish this guy did this a lot more often. You know, if he does this and plays like this a lot more often, he can be amazing. But he needs to know that, can you play like this when you are more tightly marked and teams are a lot more defensive? That's the other question. I did like what Wilmots did. I mean, obviously he wasn't really as extravagant as what Hazard did, but I think Wilmots in the middle with nine goal, and they formed a very good midfield partnership. So this Belgium team, look, man, it's their special generation. These are the best group of players that the country has ever had. Because I remember when the Wilmots and Mpenza used to play back in the day for Belgium, and they were always like that average side that you always knew that they would get beat. But Hazard has arrived. De Bruyne, and for me, I don't care what anyone says, Belgium need the both of them. For Belgium to win the Euros, they need both Hazard and De Bruyne. They need both of them because, again, they just, I think, with De Bruyne gives Belgium something very important, and he gives them something different, and you need the variation. If it's all on Hazard's shoulders, I don't think that is enough. But again, last final word, well done to Hungary. Played very well, really good team, and had a very good Euro, so they should not feel shameful about what they've done. I just think they just played the wrong tactics against a team who had better players than them. For Belgium, amazing performance. It could have been 6 or 7 goals. And Hazard, man, it was a great G. Had an assist, but that was an amazing goal and just a super, super performance. And finally, because remember what I've been saying for a long time, that Hazard has never had a man-of-the-man performance for Belgium. He's never shown up for Belgium. And what a way to, first of all, score his first goal at a major tournament for Belgium. And also, first time that he's really taking the game by the scruff of the neck and really being the main man for Belgium. So for Hazard, maybe this is a good omen for Belgium now. That De Bruyne has done it, now Hazard has done it, two of their star players, who knows? But again, for Wales, man, they have a lot of homework to do because they need to watch this very closely, because again, you give this team space, you will get baptized. Follow me on Twitter and on Facebook and head over to the Euro 2016 page for different polls and somewhat. Peace out, stay true and stay black. Peace.